I should have done this in the beginning of the video because now my hair does look a lot nicer. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be chatting about OLAPLEX hair products. I have been testing OLAPLEX hair for about 2 weeks now, so this is kind of like a first impressions. Side note, thank you to my mom for allowing me to steal some of her products and test them out for long enough for me to be able to understand how they work and whether or not they're worth the money, because these products are not very cheap. So I did not have the heart to buy them myself, but she actually ended up wanting to try them out for Christmas, so I got them for her for Christmas and then stole a little bit of them for this video. Essentially, each product, if I'm not mistaken, I hope I'm not, but each product is $28, and let me just show them to you really quickly. So I have OLAPLEX number 3, which is essentially a hair mask you apply right before washing your hair. So you apply this, let it sit in the hair and do its magic, and then you wash it off. So this is like a super treatment here. Then I have the number 4, which is the shampoo, and number 5, the conditioner. And then I have the number 6, bond smoother, which is essentially the stuff you put in your hair when you're styling it to smooth it out, which I'm going to actually do on camera. But let me just, before talking about the application of each product, how it felt, and then the results, let me just explain OLAPLEX as a brand, because it is a very different kind of a brand. Sorry, as you can see, the product was like this and now it's like stuck to the top, so it looks kind of funky. Anyway, so OLAPLEX as a brand is, like I said, a very scientific brand, or that's how it's trying to come across, because it's less marketing, less colors, more numbers, more formulas, more science. More science. Now, I took some notes. Now I'm gonna read them to you. Our patented active chemistry works on the molecular level to repair damaged and broken bonds in the hair that are caused by chemical, thermal, or mechanical damage. So I think right off the bat you can tell that the line is focused on strengthening the hair and repairing and rebuilding it, rather than just making it look nice and pretty and shiny. Now, speaking of health of the hair, I just want to quickly say that I personally believe in that hair is an extension of your body and your health, and this should not be your first line of defense. You should really focus, I think, on your health and making sure that your hair is healthy from within, rather than just like putting stuff on top of it. But that being said, I do use, obviously I color my hair, it's not obvious, but I do color my hair, I style it, so I use external things that damage the hair. And from that perspective, I do believe in coupling that internal health with something like this that you put on top. Now, the second thing I will say is that OLAPLEX does have a pro-only line of products. It's the 1 and the 2 that come before the 3 that you can get as a, like a regular consumer. And those are used when you're coloring your hair to strengthen the hair. And that's actually how I heard of OLAPLEX, because I would be watching hairstylists on YouTube color hair and they would all be using OLAPLEX. Not all of it, like pretty much all, a lot of them. Okay, so before I tell you what I think happened to my hair after using OLAPLEX, we're going to jump right into talking about how each product felt, how the application was, and all of that stuff. And then I'm going to talk about the end results and maybe even apply this on camera, because I feel like my hair is looking a little dry, a little frizzy, and it could use some smoother. So let's start with number 3. This is the repairs and strengthen all hair types. I thought this was a conditioner initially. I think a lot of people think that because it's like very clear and it's highlighted and everything. It says not a conditioner, it's a bond builder, make sure to wash it off, kind of a thing. So this is something you put on before shampooing your hair. It actually does not honestly feel that hydrating. I felt like I had to use a lot of this product in my hair, and I do have kind of longer hair and I do have a lot of it, so for me this would go by so quick. But yeah, I end up using a good bit of it because it just felt like it wasn't very moisturizing. I don't know, so I just dumped a lot of it on my hair and I let that sit for about 10 minutes. I've done that I think 3 times already, because I felt like this would be the product that I would be most in love with, something that's super repairing, super hydrating. Now I will say that you have to, I mean you don't have to, but they suggest apply on damp towel dried hair, and you do that before washing your hair, so really your hair is dry at this point. And like I would stick my hair in the shower, wet it, then I would like, you know, dump a lot of the water out of my hair, make it drier ish then I would put this in my hair, and I would just basically be like walking around with wet hair, this stuff in my hair, and just like waiting to take a shower. So that wasn't super pleasant. Like I don't have this pampering space that I could just like lay in and enjoy my wet hydrating hair. So that bit was like a little bit like of a, you have to not be lazy and apply this before shampooing your hair because it is kind of like an extra step, but I do think this does make a difference, which I'll talk about in just a second. So then you have your bond maintenance shampoo. Even though it's not a huge bottle, I feel like it would last for a good bit because it's so thick and it does lather well. My hair is dry, but my scalp is oily and it always washed my hair well because that's something I do care about. All those hydrating shampoos, not all but some, they tend to like not wash my scalp well, and then my hair might be like down here might be nice, but then my scalp is all greasy and oily, so it's a balance. The conditioner actually feels very thick and pasty. Ooh, oops, I gotta put that back. We're not wasting you, mister. It's almost like silicone-y, like it has a slip to it, but it's not greasy. That's sort of how this feels. After using these products for the first time, I really was not that impressed, like especially like after washing the hair, there was no difference really. Like the hair felt a little different. There was that kind of like a smoothness to it. There was a little bit of like that velvety feel, but really wasn't like groundbreaking. And again, like it's not supposed to be. It's supposed to be each consecutive use your hair is better and better, but still, like I was expecting something. Now the next day is where I saw results, because the next day my hair was very soft, shiny, smooth, and voluminous. Now it wasn't incredibly voluminous, but there was definitely volume in my hair like there wasn't before, and my hair was shiny and soft at the same time. So that's why I think the products are not as heavy as I would expect them to be, is that they don't weigh your hair down, which is a good thing, because I honestly already have kind of like, my hair is like blah already. I don't want to weigh down anymore. I do have some rough split ends, and I will say that they're still there. The products did not really improve that too much, at least not right now, but they did improve the overall feel of the hair. So when I run my fingers through the hair, my hair feels a lot softer, but when I get to the ends, they are not as soft as I would want them to be. But it does say online that these are supposed to help with everything from root to ends, so I'm working on that. Okay, so then let's just go ahead and talk about this right here. Ooh, not that one. Okay, so next let's go ahead and talk and test out the number 6 bond smoother. I have tested this out before. This is basically the stuff that you put in your hair, kind of like that slippery jelly thing that makes your hair look a lot less frizzy. On here it says a little goes a long way, and that is very, very true. Apply a very small amount to damp or dry hair, concentrating product on your mid-length to ends, comb through and style as desired. So this is something you're supposed to apply before styling your hair, but like I said, this is something we're going to be doing right now on camera. So my hair is looking a little bit dry, a little bit frizzy, which is quite normal for it. Less so than before, but still too much for my comfort. It does not feel creamy. It actually feels a little bit like the conditioner. Silicone-y maybe is the right way to describe it. So I would just do something like that. Apply, apply, apply. It smells very light and fruity, not super strong. So if you don't like the smell, which I think you will because it's a pleasant smell, but if you don't for some reason, it will not last for a long time. Now I have thicker hair, so I can, and also very dry hair, so I can use a little bit more, but this does, if you apply too much of it, it does make your hair look a little bit greasy. So just be careful with that. This does get rid of some of the volume, and it may loosen up some of your curls if you have your hair curled or styled in a certain way. So just be careful about that, which is why you're supposed to apply this before styling your hair. This also has heat protectant properties in it as well, which is a great thing because one of the ways you can prevent damage is to prevent it in the first place. That makes any sense. No, it doesn't. I should have done this in the beginning of the video because now my hair does look a lot nicer. You can see like the volume is gone, but it's probably because the volume was really frizz. And if it's a defreezer, then the frizz and the volume that comes with it are goodbye. Okay, so let me just give you guys a summary of my thoughts here because I feel like I've been rambling on and on about these products. Number one, make sure that you're feeding your body and you're treating your body with the respect and the love that it deserves, and that you're creating an environment for your body to produce the hair that is healthy and strong to begin with. Number two is making sure that you do not create a lot of damage to your hair. I personally decided to not go as light as I normally do for that reason, because my hair is already prone to being dry and coarse, and adding more bleach to it just does not make it look and feel very healthy. And also I don't use a really, really high heat tools on my hair either. I do style my hair, but I try to not use super extreme high heat. So that's tip number two. Now after all of that, this is where these products can come in. So I will say that if you want to really strengthen your hair and not just make it look good once, but really like nourish it and rebuild it in a way, then I would say you're gonna need to not just get the number 3, but also get the number 4 and number 5, the shampoo and the conditioner. It does make sense to get all 3 because it does make for more of an impact, but also makes for more of an expensive product line range, because each product is $30, roughly 28, I think, but with tax, it's roughly 30. So this would be a $90 purchase investment. And for me personally, if I had to guess, this would last for about 2 months if I'm really stretching it with my hair type, my hair length, and the fact that I would wash my hair every other day. And maybe I wouldn't use this every single time I wash my hair, but you know, often enough. This really wouldn't last for that long is what I'm saying. So it's an investment for sure. Difference is definitely there. I saw it, I felt it, it's great, but I don't know if it's enough for me to be spending $90 on a bi-monthly roughly basis to upkeep that. Yeah, that's my thoughts. It's expensive, it's good, is it worth it? I don't know. Summary. You could also skip those 3 products and just go for the number 6. This is again also $30. This will last you for a lot longer because you're using so little of it. It's not going to repair the hair the same way these 3 products will, because it's not really designed for that. It's kind of designed to prevent more damage and to smooth your hair out instantly. And also I do think it feels anyway that it would actually help heal the hair while it's on the hair, but you're not applying it on the roots. You're kind of just like applying it lightly. So I wouldn't really count on it repairing things so much as just preventing the damage and making your hair look nice. But if you want something instant, this is it. This was pretty instant as well, though, I will say, because the next day my hair was very smooth and soft and light. Obviously not as instant as something like this, because you can just like throw this on and you saw the difference. I mean, my hair was kind of frizzy. I'm regretting not putting this on in the beginning of the video, but it was an instant, like, smooth, perfect, done. And not like greasy, you know, like smooth in like a very naturally healthy way, if that makes any sense. Which is great. So, okay, on that note, I guess that's it for this video. Thanks so much for sticking around with it and watching it. And if you did enjoy it, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you have any thoughts or suggestions, leave those in the comment section below. Anything that you want to add on to this video, leave that in the comment section below, because I love learning from you guys. I'm just kind of like in this journey of trying different products out and learning for myself. So if you have any suggestions, if you're a hairdresser especially, pop that in the comment section below. We all can read and learn from you. All right, on that note, I hope you guys have a wonderful, wonderful day, and I hopefully will see you in the next video. Bye.